What we were discussed about the regarding the these things, and have you tried Bala or Suresh? You haven't tried, I know. So Bala, have you tried which I was talking about, disabling or enabling the required field validators or the validator controls? Have you tried it? Hello, Bala. Not responding. He muted his.
Hello, hello, hello.
Bala, have you tried it?
Actually, I just actually I just gone through your video today evening itself. So most probably by end of the after today's session, I will just practice and I will just complete.
See, don't be late because even the, see, I'm just going very slowly. If I wanted to complete the course within a 20 days, I can complete entire thing. But why I'm going so that you can just go and do the practice. Okay, let's start.
Yes.
Okay.
Today, definitely, I will just do it and I will just update. No problem.
Okay. Great. So we did yesterday we discussed about like uploading the images and the simple validation control. Login first. Okay. The login screen which I have created. Double clicking onto the login. I'm going to for example, first we'll go with one more thing I need to add for the state management. Selection. I'm just giving simple thing, selections. Is the design part? I'm just dragging and dropping. Otherwise, you can just go and write the code in the source side. Okay, I can do that here also. For example, ASP colon. I wanted to go for the drop-down list. I have a drop-down list. ID equals to, you need to specify DDL. Okay, DDL means drop-down list. I'm just going for the country. DDL country. Run equal to server. Equal to server. Okay. There is one more drop down. I'm just putting it. Control C. Paste. First is for we call as a country. The second the drop down is for states. I'm not going for a like how why how can I bind the data? You already did in Windows application, but the concept is totally different here. The concept is what I can do, just let's first set as this page as set as start page. See, I wanted to populate this drop down. Simple thing. Okay, so where we can write the code for that, double click on the page, it will generate your page event or page load. This is the page load event where I can put the data for the drop down. Let's do that. What we can do, I can create an array or I can put some hard-coded values, else I can create a normal, I can add a normal data here, DDL. DDL, okay. DDL country dot. I'm just putting items dot add. We have to go with the database right now just to put some hard-coded values. Now, the first value I'm just putting India. That's it. Control C, Control V, Control V, Control V. Now, I'm putting SA. Canada. Let's run it first and then see what's happening. The value is getting populated here. Okay. I wanted to, when I select the particular country from the first drop down, it should populate the states. So what I need to do, based on the selection of the second first drop down, DDL states, it should populate the other dropdown. So what I am going to do, double click on the dropdown list. It will generate an action called drop DDL country underscore selected index change. Just double click on it. It will generate an action. Okay. Let's place a breakpoint here. F5. Whenever I'm selecting India, it should go to the selected index change event. But I'm selecting here, but it is not going to the server. Even though I have created an action, what was the reason? Invoking the method. Told you, everyone. Bala, any idea?
Hello? Huh?
Bala, why it is not going whenever I am selecting something? I have created an action here. Going to the breakpoint.
I think it's not we have.
If you have gone through the last session,
can you show it again?
Suresh, I have created an action DDL country underscore selected index change. Okay, it is associated with this drop down. Go to the source, you can check it. On selected index change means whenever you are selecting something from the drop down, it should fire an action which is available. But when from the drop down, it is not going to.
Can you show me that index page again? The page.
This one or the source one? If you talk about yes.
Wait.
I have given an action. Event is there. DDL country underscore selected index change. If I have created it, so it should go here also. So that based on the selection, I can populate the state.
This is the client action it is taking there?
No, there is no client action till right now. Nothing is there. It's a just a normal thing. If you remember, yesterday we did for what we call a drop down, a radio button. Remember?
What was it
was also not firing the action.
Auto post false
because few of the controls doesn't have a default property auto post back. Let me add it. I'll just write auto post back equals to true. Now save it, refresh the browser. Now clicking onto the U Canada. See, it is going now. Auto post back means post back where server. You have to put something onto the server side. Now, okay, let's run it again. I'm not going for this. I just remove the breakpoint. See what it is happening, Suresh. Oh, what happened? See. Why it is getting added again and again, Suresh? Or Bala, tell me.
Yeah, it's getting stored in cache.
Actually, what happened is that every time the variable it is getting refreshed, so it is added again and again. So it is a stateless, so that's why it is. Adding into the same Let's variable again.
Place a breakpoint here on the payload. Whenever you fire any action, this is a Suresh, this is an HTML part. Once you rendered the HTML, once you throw the HTML to the client machine or the client browser, okay, it's totally disconnected now. Whenever I am firing any action USA, where it is going, see, again it is going to the drop page load event.
Page load, yeah.
The data is already thrown on the client side. It is all appending that on the client machine. client browser. Okay, that is why it is getting added at it. That means it's not correct one, right? See, again, it is coming to the page load event. It added it.
So yesterday you were just showing us with the that name. Today you are just firing some event and just showing, right?
Yes, nothing else.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It is not every time it is getting added the record because it is going to page load event. So the problem is because R is not here. His machine, he raised one question. He was not aware, but he knows something is written over in the code side. He has seen application. The most important part is if not is post back means see what is that? Post back means just in a general way I can say whenever you are doing any post back means you are posting something onto the server. At the side, if you remember, I asked initial day, first day of ASP.NET, what I said, the client will send a request to the server. The first request on the server side, web server, which page the client has requested, it will identify, okay, he requested country selection example.aspx. Then, okay, the server found it, then it will return the HTML. Okay, it will return the HTML along with your hidden field to the server. When you make a second request to the server again it will check, is this the same client or not? The first thing, because you are going to make a number of requests to the server. And on the request side, I have mentioned it, adding the values to the dropdown. This is the is post back property, or you can say a enum type of thing, bool type of value. It checks on the server side, is this the first request? Let's do that with the first request. Okay, then you can easily understand. And now you guys see the magic here. I refresh it, it is going to the page load, correct? Tell me, is this the first request? Yes. Is this is the first request. It will go inside it and bind the now. What happened on the server side? I'm selecting USA or the Canada. It will fire an action again. Again, it will go to the page load. Whatever the ASP.NET page life cycle is there, it will rerun. Clicking onto the Canada, again it is going to the page load. Now I check. Not is post back. This should not be the first request. That means
so the state status will be.
This is the second request. Means not true. If this is second request, it will not go and bind the data again and again. It is not going inside that. So it will not add it.
So basically this reduces the stateless character which that ASP is holding.
No. Don't combine with the stateless thing. Stateless thing means you cannot retain just one definition. You have to remember it. Okay?
Okay.
You are doing a multiple request to the server, data will not get spent. Every time data will get refreshed it. If I put it as string str here itself, string str, again it will, what it will do, see the to what you, I wanted to show you, string str, or you can say string, suppose that's a str query, something I have given. String.empty, I have mentioned it. Okay, this is the empty value. In the query, I put it something here, equals to hello. Okay, that's true. This is a global variable, Suresh. Now, can I use this str query here itself on selecting the drop down? If you want to print something onto the computer, you have to use response.write bracket str query. I'm just writing it. Str query, right? This is accessible. That's true. Let's go and check it here. coming on to the page load event. It is going inside that. This is the first request. It binded the data. That's true. Okay. In the browser, I got it. Now I'm changing some action here, clicking onto the Canada. It is again going to page load event. Now it see again, it is assigning the value because it came here. It came here. And again, you are going to assign it. So, okay, it assigned the value. It will check whether it is a first. It will not go inside that.
But actually, if you don't want it to assign the same value, means you can put this str query into East Postback in this thing, right? So yes. The values remain the same.
No, I'll tell you. Because every time assigning the values, right, it should not be. Actually, once you assign a value to a variable, why should I again and again assign the same value? Okay, so Now the problem is here, putting into the is post. Let's rerun it again. Okay. The concept should be clear because programming, you can get it from the Google itself. Okay, so let's do once again. Going to the, this is the first request. To go inside that, I have assigned the value now. Great. Came here. Now I'm selecting India, then USA. It came here. STR value is what? Empty. Because this time in the second request, it did not like went inside the.
Okay.
So initially what happened? It came here. Then it will created a variable. It recreated a variable. It didn't go inside this particular block. It came here, and here you will not find anything.
That means that it is assigning the value local variable in that East Postback in if block only. It is assigning that value basically, and after that we are getting the blank value itself, right?
If I'm not see. Let me do once again or repeat the entire thing, okay? Because everybody joined now, okay? Let's start with Akshay. Okay. Now I'm placing a breakpoint here itself in the string str. Okay. Clicking here. This is the first request. Okay. It is in here. See where it came at the class level. Till now it did not went to any method, any action. String is F10. Whether it is a first request or not, it is the first request. Yeah. Go. I have assigned the value. That's true. It assigned it. Correct. Now, means logically, my thought is if I already assign a value to str, okay, so it should be available on subsequent request whenever you are going to do that. If I'm clicking onto the Australia, again it is going to the class level, again it is recreating the variable. See, if it is recreating it, it will go to the page load, and in the page load you check, okay, is back equal to true. It means this is the second request, so it will not go inside that. The string str value is still
null. Yeah, okay, now I got to know. Yes.
One second. Whatever the data you have is stored in the first request, it is not getting maintained on the subsequent request. That is why str query is null or empty. See what it will print? Nothing on the browser. Okay. State.
Okay.
ASP.NET is a stateless protocol. Whenever you are making a second request or the subsequent request, data will maintain in any case. Either you have to assign it again and again. Okay. If you don't want to assign again, there is no use for assigning again and again, recreating the variables again and again. It's not required. It should not be happening actually. So to overcome this drawback, we have a technique called state management. To retain the data, to maintain the data on subsequent request, we do have state management. Akshay, is that clear? Or Tushar?
Yes, sir, clear.
Management, that's true.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, Bala.
Yeah, actually your voice was not audible. Yes, sir.
Okay,
yeah.
Might be because there is some internet issue from the morning itself. Okay, I'll tell you frankly. I just called to the customer care. He told, okay, you just reset it. I resetted it 1.5 hours back. Might you will get some issue.
Okay, okay, fine, no problem. Yeah.
Okay, see, this is the issue. This is the reason why we have injected a statement. Start with the state management, then we'll go with the databases and all those things. We will implement architecture. I will not go to double click on the button and write everything. Whatever we did in the Windows application, we will not go. For working. So in a totally what are state management techniques? Is visible?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I can write it into the notepad itself if you want. Otherwise, if you are able to see that, that's really great. See, we should not learn each and everything of the state management techniques, but I'll tell you, okay? There are two types of state management techniques. We can maintain the data at the client side, and we can maintain the data at the server side. And you guys have to create an example application for me using client side or the server side. Once you've done that, I'll tell you, in the state management, the techniques or whatever the things we have in the state management, it's cleared everything. I'll ask you some scenarios, okay, at the end of the today's session. Okay, let's start with the two types of techniques we do have, a client side or the server side. The client side techniques, we have a view state, control state. Control state, it's not required. Okay, it's nothing but it is an inbuilt feature actually. You don't need to do anything. View state, hidden fields, cookies, query string at the client side. Now, let's start with the view state first. Okay. View state is what? Anybody have any idea?
No.
Okay. See, this is the browser. Oh, let's open any website, gmail.com. Anything you can use it. Gmail, or you can just open this particular page. Right clicking onto it, click on view page source. Just type, see, this is what view state. I have not created it, but the ASP.NET itself creating a view state. In the ASP.NET page lifecycle, we do have one action or the event, load view state, in the ASP.NET page lifecycle itself. Okay, so why the ASP.NET is maintaining the view state itself? It is maintaining for your controls. Some of the controls, not for every control, means button, text boxes, and label values, it is getting maintained. So if I'm talking about to maintain the data at the client side, the first feature would be a view state. Just make a note for that. I'm not writing. Okay, if you can write it at your end, that's nice. Otherwise, you can see the recording sessions. View state, for example, just let's see the first basic example, then you can easily understand. This is the string str query, okay? I'm not able to get this value on the drop-down selection, because every post back, every time I'll make a point on post back, okay, just remember, post back means you are hitting a server code. Whenever you are doing a post back by drop down selection, combo box selection, radio button selection, button click, text box text change, anything, whenever you are doing a post back, it will cursor will come here on the class level. It will recreate the objects, recreate the variables, recreate the classes, instances, and everything every time. So my intention is, if I already
created a variable on top. I checked his post back. On the first request, if I maintain the data on the str variable, on the second subsequent request, I'm not able to get the value. If I want to maintain the data of this variable value, I can write in a simple words, view state. I tell you the definition as well. This is the view state. The key which you need to specify, I'm writing a key name. I'll just make a note of value. Anything you can give a key name. Equals to, what I did, I have put it as str query. The first request only. Now, on the second request, I check this thing. If this view state value is not equal to null, if it is not null, query equals to view state semicolon. I can put it like this. And if you want to typecast it, because this is an object, state back control, okay? You want to control, if you want to specify this, either you can go and write to string, or else you have a other way for typecasting it. It's a here you can write round brackets and put it like this. Now let's see that. I'm just stopping this browser in. Okay, let's. Clicking onto the. Oh, sorry. I forgot to add a breakpoint here. It's coming to the page load. This is the first request. Okay, it should go inside it. I captured the value in the str query. I captured the str query value in the view state. Let's right click, select that particular word first. Then see the view state value is getting maintained here. Now, continue. I'm selecting India, then clicking onto the Canada. Again, it is going to the for the post back. It will go here. Okay, this is true. That means it is a second request. Okay, if it is the second request, it will not go inside that. So on the first request, I already maintained the previous. Just select it. See the value is available or not. See the value is available. So I can get the value here itself. I can reassign it and I can paste it and I will get the data on the screen, the hello. Got it? View state data. This data would be available on subsequent request or multiple requests for the same page. If I'm hitting multiple times of the page, I have captured the variable.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Tell me.
Yeah, yeah. Voice was not. Tell me, sir. Yeah.
Yes. See, I have what I checked. I checked. Okay. I have already specified the value in the view state. That should be on the subsequent request, or you can say a multiple request, or the next request. Now, I'm trying to get the value on the button click itself. Let's copy it and paste it. Okay. Now let's rerun it. Again, I'm just printing it. Let's run. I'm placing a breakpoint here itself. Here itself. Again, here itself if you want. It's going here. Is this the first request? See? No. Yes, yes. First request, it
I captured.
Yeah. Going here, this is the second request. you want to maintain it? We are talking about that's a view state. See, I got a value here itself. Hello. Okay. Again, it is going to the page load. Okay. It should not go because this is the third, not a first request. Now it will go to the page. See, I'm just checking. Quick watch. See, the value is still available. The different click event, and I'll be able to print the data. Overwriting the previous data, that's it. The value is available. I'm talking about this thing only. Means on the subsequent request or the multiple request, whenever you are doing or making any post back, if you want to maintain that data at the page level, means still my page is country selection example. At the page level, if you want to maintain the data on multiple request, you have to use a view state concept. Any doubt, any clear, tell me.
ये लाइब्रेरी का आप एक कुछ एग्जांपल आप बता सकते हो सर कहां पे मींस यूज होता है नॉर्मली
वेट फॉर अ सेकंड जस्ट आई डिड आई जस्ट वांटेड टू अंडरस्टैंड वेदर यू इज दिस क्लियर और नॉट
ओके
यू टेल मी अक्षय तुषार एनी क्वेश्चंस
क्लियर क्लियर सर क्लियर है
ओके अक्षय एनी डाउट
नो
ओके लेट्स डू दैट फर्स्ट Then we'll see. The next is Bala. I'll come to you regarding your requirement or something. Okay, we'll do that. Now, on the drop-down selection, I wanted to populate the for the state. That's true. Okay. Commenting it for now, or we'll just leave it for this thing. In this slide. Now you guys tell me, I'm creating a variable here. Whenever the user is selecting something, based on that, it will populate the data of that second dropdown. Okay. Well, first I need to get the value, what value he has selected from the dropdown. So in the simple words, I am just creating one variable, str selected, or how can we write it? Selected country, I'm just writing, okay, equals to whatever the values you have selected from the drop down ddl dot, there is a property called selected item or selected value, anything you can use it. I'm just using selected text. I got this value. Now you guys tell me, let's see, I can put some hard coded values here right now. If country double equals to India, okay, India, please mute Bala. Okay, I wanted to populate the other drop down, so I'll make it as ddl state dot items dot add in bracket. I can put state means MH means Maharashtra, simple. Put something like this, copy paste, it's white, simple. Tell you, let's see that. In the same way I can put it for the other else conditions. You have to go with the database. Okay, now for see this, we say I'm just putting as Chicago, just follow this. Just ask you a few more things over here, then we can proceed it. Okay, it is not populated yet. Selecting a USA, it is going to the drop down selected index. What is the value? USA, I have selected it. Now F10, it is going here, it is going inside that, and it will get populated. True. Now Chicago and America,
Now I am selecting a India now. Clicking on to the India. What is the value? India. F10 it is. Now see, I have selected a India. And here what happened?
To clear the state drop down.
Yes, because once you throw the HTML to the client machine, sir, not be responsible for anything what you did. For example, I press F12 key. I can make some changes here itself. I can make some changes. Means hacker can do anything here itself. I can do it. I can remove it. I can do it. So that's why. The server will not be responsible for that in any case. See, I'm deleting elements. Some the server will not be responsible. See, so whenever you are going to populate the next drop down, you have to clear the item first, then you can go and do that. India, USA, okay, gets populated. Again, I'm just going to India. Now, everything gets populated. USA, this. Correct. Good. Now, you guys tell me. The requirement is what? What is a button click? I wanted to print something of the selected value of the drop. Dot. Sorry. Response dot write and just writing CDL country dot selected item. I can just see that. I'm just printing the drop down selected country. Not placing the viewpoint. Okay. A USA. Gets populated, click on button. USA, correct. India, the button, India. That's true. Canada. Everything is getting populated. That's true. Okay, let's do one more important thing here itself. You should not use a view state like what I did, what I wrote. I know many people, 90% people, they are assigning the value here itself like this. Not good. Okay? Just make an habit, whatever I am going to do right now.